So we're all using these kind of incredible AI tools, right? Like ChatGPT, Claude. But what if the price of all those convenience is our ability to think, and which is so core to us being human? We're going to dive into a hidden cognitive trap that honestly almost all of us walk into. Today I'm going to tell you that even you think you are a critical thinking person, you never outsource your critical thinking to AI, but it will still happen even without you knowing it. And you might be shocked how deeply it goes. So to really get where we might be heading, we will have to go back, way back to a classic comedy from 2005. Hey, welcome back to Second Order Thinkers. I'm Jane, and this channel is dedicated to one thing: helping you see what most people miss. Now, you likely heard of this comedy, Idiocracy. It was supposed to be this ridiculous scene and making fun of the current phenomenon that people are getting dumber, a total joke. But the unsettling thing is that it is starting to feel less like a joke and more like a documentary. It shows a complete and total collapse of critical thoughts. Now, here's the thing. The movie's whole punchline was that this crazy decline would probably take 500 years. 500. But what if the cause isn't like what this movie shows, some kind of a slow-moving genetic evolution, but instead AI? So what if something happening right now and the timeline isn't centuries, but maybe just a decade or two? That brings us to the Idiocracy prophecy, and really how a joke about future is becoming a warning for today. The whole premise of this movie is super simple. An average guy from our time wakes up after 500 years and boom, he becomes the smartest person on Earth. The really brilliant part isn't that he is the smartest. It wasn't about him getting any smarter, not at all. It was about everyone else. They just forgot how to think. They lost the ability to reason, to solve problems, and to think critically. So you could say that movie might gotten the destination right, but it totally got the vehicle wrong. The whole argument that we're digging into today, however, is that the real driving force behind this whole tendency towards idiocracy, artificial intelligence. And about that timeline, forget 500 years. We're talking about maybe 10 to a few decades. Okay, so this brings us to the big crucial question here. So are we outsourcing our critical thinking? It's actually no longer a question, because it's been proven again and again that the more we interact with AI and the less we try to intentionally solve the problem ourselves, the more we rely on this machine. And look, we do it all the time that we use calculators to help us with math, we have grocery lists so we don't forget things, no big deal. But here's the difference. We don't just offload simple memory tasks to AI, but we're really in danger of offloading the whole process of thinking itself, and subsequently, we're also outsourcing our human agency. What's so sneaky and insidious about this is that we don't even realize we're doing it. Part of this study that inspired this video today, they have found those people who are professional thinkers, like researchers, who initially insisted that they were thinking for themselves while they are using AI. However, the finding shows that they unconsciously based all their arguments on whatever ChatGPT said first. Now, if that group of people we typically deem smart can't spot this kind of pattern on their own, what chances do the rest of us have? Okay, let's not go all doom and gloom, I promise. The good news is that this study also found a proven way to fight this effect. And you can think of it like a workout plan for your brain in the age of AI. So here's how they did it. The researchers took 150 people and split them into four different groups. The tasks are simple. Write a reasoned argument about democracy. Now, you had one group had no AI at all, just humans. A second group that could use ChatGPT. There's also a third group that used ChatGPT, however, following a very structured methodology. And the final group that's AI output on its own and as a baseline. So the result is on one hand really staggering, but on the other, if you're someone who's familiar with this subject, it probably also wouldn't surprise you. The group just used AI casually, that they barely did better than AI on its own without human interactions. But the group that used the structural method saw this massive leap in quality. And this proves it. It's not about if you use AI or not, it's how you use it. And it makes all the difference. So, what was the secret sauce? This magic method, it's a five-step process called structured prompting. So, what was this secret sauce? The magic method, it's a five-step process called structured prompting. And the principle behind it is actually super simple. You start by thinking for yourself first. Thing you do is to understand what problem you're trying to solve, understand your idea, and then and only that you would use AI as a research assistant to find specific facts, rather than asking it to write for you outright. Then afterwards, you build your own argument. Use AI as a sparring partner to poke holes in your logic. Finally, when people ask you, hey, did you write this? And then you will still be able to talk about the content. The whole process is about augmenting your brain, not replacing it. One of the participants in the study actually put it quite perfectly. They said, using AI alone feels like fast food. It's quick, it's easy, and it's delicious, but you don't really know what you're getting. But the structured prompting here, it's just like cooking. Yes, it takes more effort, but you are in a complete control in what kind of nutritions you take. This is such a great way to put it. So now we have a solution. Yay, happy day, awesome. No, hang on, stop here. Because here is a giant obstacle on the road, and this is actually the key point I want to talk to you. This solution requires effort, and the whole AI industry is economically designed and incentivized to prompt the exact opposite, total effortless. You have to understand there is a fundamental conflict of interest here. AI companies make more money when you use their chatbot constantly for quick, frictionless answers. They literally profit from your dependency rather than your improved thinking. Your long-term cognitive health is just not on their balance sheet. Look, if you think about this, we have actually seen this exact pattern before. It isn't new. This business model of maximizing engagement, removing friction, even when it's bad for users, is the same playbook used by the fast food industry, big tobacco, and social media companies. AI is just the newest chapter in this very, very old story. Now you might be sitting there and thinking, okay, I get it. I just be disciplined and I will become a cognitive gym goer. And that's great. Here's the problem. You can't really escape the consequence when the rest of society largely chooses to stay on the couch and not do their thinking. This isn't a problem that you can solve just for yourself. Here's another study I brought in my writing, and that's why it makes it so urgent. This problem isn't new. We have alarming data showing that our collective reasoning skills have already gone down long before the chatbot shows up. So AI isn't starting the fire, it's just pouring gasoline all over it. Let me give you an analogy. NHS in the UK, that we all pay into the systems that covers everyone, right? Including those people who smoked for 40 years or decide not to go to the gym but eat fast food every day. Well, a society with declining cognitive ability works the same way. You will need to pay your fair share of tax. or whatever format it would be in the future to cover things that other people decide not to do in their life. We end up paying for them in ways that we couldn't even imagine right now. So what are the potential costs that we're talking about? Well, it could mean a stagnant economy because you can't find people who actually solve problems anymore. It could mean a political system that's incredibly vulnerable to manipulation and demagoguery because the public just can't tell the difference between a good argument and a bad one. It means real massive healthcare costs from cognitive decline that we all end up paying for. I mean, the stakes couldn't be higher. So this brings us to our final point. We are at this giant crossroads. The choices we make are individual, but the consequences, well, those are for everyone. Now let's recap where we are. We have this unbelievably powerful tool, AI. We have a scientifically proven technique to use it to our benefit to make us smarter. But we are up against this entire system, the entire AI industry that is designed to push us down the path of least resistance. The only thing standing in the way is our own willpower. If this perspective resonates with you, if you want someone who thinks at the second level instead of just reacting to the obvious, subscribe to this channel. Before you go away, I'm going to leave you with this question. How willing are you personally to fight the system that is designed from the ground up to make you stop thinking?